Hello dear students, today in this video lecture we are going to study a topic of vibration. Okay, so basically in previous videos we have studied regarding vibration, that vibration is basically a force which repeats itself after an equal interval of time, that we have already studied. So today we are going to discuss how to find out natural frequency of free vibration. Okay, so for finding out the natural frequency we are having three different methods. First one is the equilibrium method, second one is the energy method, and third one is the Rayleigh method. So we will find equation of motion and the equation of natural frequency of vibration today by using the first equilibrium method. So dear students, first we are going through this figure. Now this is the basic figure of spring mass system. Here in first figure it is a free spring with stiffness k. Second one is the same spring with stiffness k, but we are attaching the m amount of mass here. After attaching the m amount of mass, in third case we are applying the external force for vibration purpose. Okay, so these are the three different method. After free spring, while attaching a mass m, there is a deflection of delta st amount. We are assuming that after attaching the m amount of mass, spring will go in downward direction with deflection of delta st. Now in third, if we are applying any external type of force, हमने पहले force apply करना है, ठीक है? तो force apply किया तो वो vibration चालू होगा. So after applying force, one more x amount का वो डिफ्लेक्शन करेगा. सो इन लास्ट टोटल डिफ्लेक्शन इज डेल्टा एस टी प्लस एक्स आफ्टर अप्लाइंग मास एंड एक्सटर्नल फोर्स. ओके, नाउ हाउ टू फाइंड आउट इक्वेशन ऑफ मोशन ऑफ फ्री वाइब्रेशन बाय यूजिंग दिस इक्विलिब्रियम मेथड. सो हियर वी कैन सी दिस इज द फोर्स बॉडी डायग्राम. ओके, नाउ अकॉर्डिंग टू द इक्विलिब्रियम मेथड द जनरल इक्वेशन इज इनर्शिया फोर्स इज इक्वल टू समेशन ऑफ ऑल द एक्सटर्नल फोर्सेज. Now here which different types of forces are acting, that we are going to see. Now actually if we are applying the external force, there is a accelerative force, it can be said as a inertia force, it is acting in the downward direction. So that force is mx double dot. Okay, same way if we are attaching the any amount of mass, there will be a gravitational force in the downward direction by its own mass m. So mg force will act in the downward direction. But here spring, now spring is a elastic body, we all know that. जैसे ही spring को हम खींचेंगे, spring अपने आप को खुद को वापस खींचने का प्रयास करेगा. So it is known as the restoring force. Okay. So जैसे हम inertia force downward direction में लगाएंगे, ऐसे ही spring अपने आप का force खुद का opposite direction में in upward direction, that force will be restoring force known as k delta st plus x. Okay, so this is the force body diagram. There are three different forces are acting. First one is the inertia force, gravitational acceleration force, and third one is the spring restoring force. These three forces are acting. Okay, now as per the principle, inertia force is the summation of external forces. So we are applying this. So first one is the mx double dot. Okay, how we are considering here forces as a positive and negative one. So it is a simple rule here. Downward direction forces are considered as a positive forces, and in upward direction forces are considered as a negative forces. Okay, so if we are applying, so it is mx double dot. It is the inertia force, mx double dot is equal to summation of all the external forces. So it is mg force plus k delta st plus x plus, but here we are considering negative sign. Why? Because it is in the acting in the upward direction, so it is in negative. So by giving simple form, mx double dot is equal to mg minus k delta st minus kx. Okay, but now watching this first figure, while simple m amount of mass is attached, no external force is given, so the equation will be from that figure number 2, the equation is K delta ST is equal to mg. Here mg amount of force is acting and opposite, uska oppose karne wala force jo hai spring force, it is acting in the upward direction. From figure 2, जब तक हमने एक्सटर्नल फोर्स नहीं लगाया तब तक यही फिगर पे ऊपर से हम इक्वेशन बनाए. सो इट इज के डेल्टा एस टी इज इक्वल टू एम जी. सो इन प्लेस ऑफ के डेल्टा एस टी वी आर पुटिंग एम जी हियर. सो एम जी वेन जी विल बी गॉन. सो इक्वेशन विल बी एम एक्स डबल डॉट इज इक्वल टू माइनस के एक्स. ओके, सो के एक्स को हम राइट हैंड साइड, लेफ्ट हैंड साइड से राइट हैंड साइड लाएंगे तो एम एक्स डबल डॉट प्लस के एक्स इज इक्वल टू जीरो. सो इक्वेशन विल बिकम x डबल डॉट प्लस k बाय एम एक्स इज इक्वल टू जीरो. इसको इक्वेशन को हमने क्या किया, डिवाइडेड दिस इक्वेशन बाय m. सो विल गेट x डबल डॉट प्लस k बाय एम एक्स इज इक्वल टू जीरो. सो दिस पोर्शन k बाय एम इज नॉन एज ओमेगा एन स्क्वायर इज इक्वल टू k बाय एम. सो हैंस वी कैन से दैट ओमेगा एन इज इक्वल टू अंडर रूट k बाय एम. सो ओमेगा एन इज इक्वल टू अंडर रूट k बाय एम, where omega n is the natural frequency of vibration while k is the spring stiffness and m is the mass of that particular system. So by equilibrium method we can easily find out omega n is equal to under root k by m, and this equation x double dot plus k by m x is equal to 0 is known as equation of motion of free vibration by using this equilibrium method. So hope you all have discussed regarding this equilibrium method, so it is understandable to all of you. So in next lecture we are going to study energy method. We will going to find this equation of motion by using the energy method. So till that, thank you so much.